7. Are you reading the poem? Did you read this poem in your home? A Night with a Wolf by Bayard Taylor from Pennsylvania, USA. Can you remember the summary of the poem? Here, it is a conversation between a father and his son. Father is calling his son to his lap and hear his experience when he passed through a forest. And he is asking the son to kiss him for sharing this story. So we will continue the poem reading. His wet foot pressed against me. Each of us warmed the other. Each of us felt in the stormy dark that beast and man was a brother. In the last class, we have finally seen that the father is asking to the son, do not be frightened, when he was explaining that during the night, it was a thick darkness, stormy night. During the time of raining and the wind was blowing heavily, and he somehow tried to hide himself under a fir tree. Behind that there was a rock. Immediately there appeared a wolf, and he was telling that throughout the night they stayed together, and telling to the boy or son, do not be feared about hearing that I stayed with a wolf throughout that night, because it didn't do any harm to him. He is telling that they became friends there. More than that, we can see that here we read his wet foot pressed against me. Whose wet foot pressed against him? The wolf wet foot pressed against him. Then each of them warmed the other. Each of them got warm. What is the meaning of fur? F-U-R, the short, fine, soft hair of certain animal. Here the hair of a wolf. It was wet because it was the time of raining. During that night there was a severe raining. As a result, the body of the wolf was wolves became wet. So the fur or the hair of his body was wet. You can see wolf here, and the body of the wolf is covered with fur. Okay. Each of us warmed the other. So they got warm each other as the result of staying together. such type of expression you have seen in the last lesson in the house of the poor family where Mrs. March visited. Can you remember that expression? In the lesson a Merry Christmas, see this sentence. Six children are huddled into one bed to keep from freezing, for they have no fire. The lady, Mrs. March, visited a poor family and she has watched in their house. Six children are huddled or nestled closely into one bed to keep from freezing, for they have no fire. So when you stay close one another, it may create some warm hotness. It is helpful to overcome freezing stage or cold climate. In the picture you can see how these children are nestled together. Okay, as the result they are getting heat, such a way they can overcome the freeze climate, freezing state of the climate. They can overcome coldness. This poor family overcome coldness or a freezing state during the winter season by sleeping together in a bed to help them to get warm. Here also you see the same expression, his wet fur pressed against me. Each of us warmed the other. During that heavy raining night, they both became warmed when they stayed together. Okay, the narrator and the wolf. Each of us felt in the stormy dark that beast and man was brother. See, they got a different feeling in that night. What was that? A brotherly feeling. They both realized that they should be friend in order to overcome such type of climate. Okay, here also you have a question to answer from the question number 2b. His wet foot pressed against me. Each of us warmed the other. Each of us felt in the stormy dark that beast and man was brother. See, you have to answer this question with a reference to the contest from the red portion today. Before that, we have another question. A 2A, see it, little one come to my knee. Hear how the rain is pouring over the roof in the pitch dark night, and the winds in the wood a roaring. That we have already completed reading, but we didn't answer it. Did you find out the answer for that question? There are three questions. After writing reference with the contest, you have to answer these three questions. First, who is the speaker here? And who is the little one? Second, what does the speaker bring to the little one's attention? Third, Do you think the wind can actually roar? There the expression has given as roaring wind. Which figure of speech is being used here in order to talk about the winds? You have to answer that. Children, please take a screenshot of this page. Second, answer this question with a reference to the context. A. Little one, come to my knee. Hark, how the rain is pouring. Over the roof, in the pitch dark night. And the winds in the woods a roaring. Reference. These lines have been taken from the poem A Night with a Wolf, written by Bayard Taylor. It is from class 7 Moonbeam textbook. Okay, contest is over. Next, no, reference is over. Next, context. The speaker draws the attention of the child to tell him a story of the speaker in a similar night when the rain was pouring and the wind was roaring. This is the context for that quoting. Next, questions should be answered. First, who is the speaker here? And who is the little one? Can you answer? Can you not answer? Okay, see the answer. The speaker here is the father, and the little one referred to is a child. Okay, second question. What does the speaker bring to the little one's attention? What is the answer? The father draws the child's attention to the rain pouring over the roof. He also makes the child listen to the roaring wind. Okay, third question. Do you think the winds can actually roar? Which figure of speech is being used here in order to talk about the winds? Answer. No. Wind cannot roar. The wind cannot really roar. Personification is used here. Which figure of speech is used here? Personification is used here to talk about the wind. Okay, the answer is over. Okay, B, 2B, his wet foot pressed against me, each of us warmed the other, each of us felt in the stormy dark that beast and man was a brother. Okay, the reference, these lines have been taken from the poem A Night with a Wolf, written by Bayard Taylor from class 7 English Literature textbook Moonbeam. Then context. In the poem, a father shares his forest life experience with his son during the stormy night in the midst of blowing wind and heavy rain. He saw a wolf lay down beside him, where he began to hide himself. This is the context of the line. This is the context of these lines. these lines. Okay, questions. Okay, students, first question. Who is the speaker talking about in these lines? The answer is, the speaker is talking about the wolf in these lines. Wolf. Second, what is he speaking about in this line? The poet want to convey that in the face of any calamity, people put aside their differences and work as one. Okay, please see that answer is belong to third question. Okay, so I made a mistake in the second question's answer. Please listen carefully. So I wrote that one below the third question answer. See, this is the question and answer of the second one. Second question, what is he speaking about? Okay, answer, he is telling his son about an encounter with a wolf. This is the answer for the second question. I am repeating that second question and answer again. Please listen carefully. What is he speaking about? This is the question. So carefully listen the answer. He is telling his son, the father is telling his son about an encounter with a wolf. This is the answer for the second question. Okay. So here I cut the answer of the second question and I wrote the last. Okay. Then come to the third question. Explain the line that beast and man was brother. Okay, the answer is, in this line the poet want to convey that in the face of any calamity, people put aside their differences and work as one. Okay, so the answer is over here. Let us continue the reading of the remaining portion of the poem. And when the falling forest no longer crushed in warning, you can assume the situation there during this night. It was a stormy night when heavy rain was outpouring and wind was beating very heavily. So now what happened? It became little calm. There became little bit calm. Then each of us went from our hiding place forth in the wild wet morning. Okay, now morning came, the end has over, the night has over, there came the morning. Then what happened? Each of us, who are they here? Who are here? What is the meaning of us here? Us imply here the father of the son with whom he is sharing his story. The narrator or the speaker and the wolf, they got departed when the morning came. Darling, kiss me in payment for how the wind is roaring. Father's house is a better place when the stormy rain is pouring. In the beginning, we have seen that the speaker want to narrate his story with the child similar to a night when the wind is roaring and rain is pouring. In this context, father has called the son to his lap and shared or explained this story with his son. So for this story, he is asking the child to kiss him. Darling, lovely, beloved, kiss me in payment. Or listen how the wind is roaring. Still the wind is roaring there. He is telling that father's house is better place when the stormy rain is pouring. After all, the speaker is telling father's house is safe during this atmosphere to be safe. Okay, read this poem, understand it. If you have anything to ask regarding this poem and the lesson, you can ask me in WhatsApp and I will be able to clarify your doubt there. Okay, come to the portion, read to appreciate. Once we have seen that, here you have to learn a literary technique as alliteration. That is alliteration. Read this line from the poem, where the wild man watched and waited. This is a line from the poem, where the wild man watched and waited. See the line, each highlighted words, where, wild, watch, waited. These highlighted words begin with the same sound. If you listen, you can see that these four highlighted words begin with the same sound. This repetition of sound at the beginning of words appearing close to each other is known as alliteration. What is called alliteration? This is the definition for alliteration. What is that? Repetition of sound at the beginning of words appearing close to each other is known as alliteration. Such repetition of sounds in a poem gives a musical quality to it, to the poem. Therefore, poet use alliteration in their poem. Why do poet use alliteration? Because such repetition of sounds in a poem gives a musical quality to it. Therefore, poet use alliteration, the technique, in their poem. You have to learn it. What is alliteration? Why do poet apply it in a poem? Okay, this is your homework for tomorrow. Learn what is alliteration and why do poet use it. Then write a paragraph about animal caring. In that animal caring paragraph, you have to mention both pet animal caring as well as wild animal caring. You can refer books, periodicals, and take help from internet, etc. Submit to me in my WhatsApp number 9174820440. Okay, you can ask clarification if you need in our WhatsApp group, class 7. Thank you.